सबको नमस्कार। ये हिंदी में बोलना है अथवा अंग्रेजी में, या मतलब क्या कोई विधान है?
अच्छा okay.
चलिए ठीक है, तो मैं ऐसा ही प्रयास करता हूँ
आपकी सुविधा अनुसार।
मैं ऐसा ही प्रयास करता हूँ, अंग्रेजी में ही बोल देता हूँ, चूंकि मेरे ख्याल से
शर्तियाँ पाबंदी नहीं है भरत जी।
अच्छा,
शर्तियाँ पाबंदी नहीं है।
चलिए मैं मान गया, तो प्रारंभ करता हूँ। आप सबको नमस्कार, श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। आज मैंने जो विषय रखा है, अभिनव गुप्त कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ रस, यानी ऐसी क्या विशेषता है अभिनव गुप्त के रस विचार में, अगर कहें तो। अब ऐसा तो नहीं है कि मैं कोई बहुत बड़ी नई खोज करके आप लोगों के समक्ष कुछ चीज़ रख पाऊँगा, ना ऐसी संभावना है, लेकिन एक दो विचार मेरे मन में हैं कि अभिनव गुप्त जी ने एक नई प्रकार की धारा का प्रारंभ किया। आज शांत रस के विषय में तो बोलना शायद ठीक नहीं रहेगा, क्योंकि वो स्वयं में एक बहुत बड़ा विषय है। इट्स अ वेरी लार्ज टॉपिक एंड ग्रेट स्कॉलर्स हैव रिटन। आई पर्सनली बिलीव दैट इन थिएटर, मे बी इन पोइट्री विच इज रेड इन आइसोलेशन, बट इन थिएटर देर इज नो शांत रस। इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल टू हैव शांत रस बिकॉज देर विल बी नो विभाव, नो अनुभाव और शांत। इफ यू आर शांत देन यू आर शांत। आप ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा बड़े बड़े नर्तक और नर्तकियाँ क्या दिखाते हैं कि वो बैठ जाते हैं एक पद्मासन में और अभय मुद्रा दिखा देते हैं और ध्यान की कोई और दूसरी हस्त मुद्रा, और मान लिया जाता है कि ये शांत है। तो जहाँ अनुभव ही नहीं होगा, वहाँ शांत रस का परिपोषण कैसे होगा? खैर, ये फिर भी एक बहुत बड़े विवाद का और चर्चा का विषय है, मैं उसमें नहीं जा रहा। जो बात आज मैं आपके सामने रखना चाहता हूँ, क्योंकि मुझे लगता है कि मेरे पास सिर्फ 20 मिनट है के करीब हैं, क्योंकि 4 बजे तक ये सेशन है, इसमें थोड़ा सा डिस्कशन होगा और हमारे अति विद्वान सहयोगी राधा वल्लभ जी को भी पर्याप्त समय देना है, तो मैं 21 मिनट में अपनी बात संक्षेप में कह के समाप्त करता हूँ। नाउ व्हाट आई वांट टू से फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इज दैट अभिनव गुप्त इज स्टैंडिंग ऑन द शोल्डर्स ऑफ भट्ट नायक। दैट ऑफ कोर्स इज वेरी वेल नोन। सम पीपल थिंक दैट, लाइक शेल्डन पॉलक थिंक्स दैट ही इज नॉट एट ऑल ओरिजिनल because he's just taken almost everything from Bhatt Nayak and Sadharani Karan he has accepted and uses that as a launching pad, which of course is true, but in the Indian tradition, standing on the shoulders of those who have gone before you is a norm. There is no business of copyright or originality here. What others have thought and given, and Abhinav Gupta says this very explicitly in Abhinav Bharati, as you all know. Now, he accepts Sadharani Karan, but he adds something very special. You see, Abhinav Gupta is a little different from others because he states very clearly, his first presumption is that only a sensitive and a highly appreciative person, technically called a sahriday, can experience the joy of ras. तो रस सबको नहीं मिल सकता। अगर बचपन से आपको सहृदय नहीं बनाया गया है, वो संस्कार नहीं है, कम से कम इस जन्म का संस्कार नहीं है, तो रस की प्राप्ति नहीं हो सकती, रस का आस्वादन नहीं हो सकता, किसी भी विधा में, नाट्य हो, काव्य हो, whatever. Now, he of course explains Sadharanikaran in his own way. Explaining Sadharanikaran, Abhinav says that on seeing the deer being chased by Dushyanta, the spectator knows that the deer is afraid, but there is no earthly reality. Vishesh Roop Abhava. So in earthly terms, in sensory terms, देर इज ए अभाव नॉन एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ सेंसरी एक्सपीरियंस बिकॉज दिस इज अ थिएट्रिकल एक्सपीरियंस टू विच दिस फियर कैन बी रिलेटेड एज द चेजर इज अनरियल एंड द चेज इज नॉट रियल इन स्पेस एंड टाइम सो विशेष रूप अभाव Therefore, Abhinav says that the spectator is neither afraid himself, nor does he think that the actor is really afraid. Nor does he think that the other than the actor, any other dramatis personae, is a friend or a foe of the spectator. Personal reactions to a friend or foe can detract the spectator from fully feeling the dramatically represented emotions, such reactions being set aside, that is, they are non-existent. The dramatically represented emotion, in this case fear, looms large before the spectator's eyes and goes straight into the heart. अब यहां देखिए ये बात है गो स्ट्रेट इन टू द हार्ट एज भयानक रस एट दिस मोमेंट द आत्मा ऑफ द स्पेक्टेटर इज नाइदर असर्टिव नॉर सबड्यूड सो इट इज नॉट असर्टिंग इट सेल्फ इन एनी पर्सनल वे नॉर इट इज सबड्यूड टोटली टू द एक्सटेंट दैट इज इट इज इनकेपेबल ऑफ एक्सपीरियंसिंग In other words, the self of the spectator is not reacting normally. Now, normally means normally in the world, because in the world either we dislike things or we like things or we are indifferent. But here, this is a state which is different from all three situations. The spectator is not reacting normally, that is to say, dramatic emotions is impersonal and hence felt in a special way. Emotional states in daily life can never be felt in such a way or be stripped of personal reactions. So this is the thing which he more or less follows Bhattanayak and reaffirms Sadharanikaran. But now he adds something. There is another dimension which Abhinav added to Rasa investigation. Lolnat and Shankuk were content to analyze what went on the stage. Bhattanayak widened the perspective by including the psychology of the spectator. तो अगर हम चार प्रस्थान कह लें या चार बड़े व्याख्याकार कहें तो उसमें पहले दो जो हैं भट्ट लोलट और शंकुक वो इस बात से ज़्यादा प्रभावित हैं कि नाट्य रंगमंच पर जो हो रहा है उसमें क्या हो रहा है द सेंटर द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन इज देयर एज टू व्हाट इज हैपनिंग बट भट्टनायक ब्रिंग्स इट टू साधारणीकरण विच मीन्स वॉट इज हैपनिंग इन द हार्ट और इन द माइंड ऑफ द स्पेक्टेटर सो फ्रॉम हियर इट शिफ्ट्स टू द स्पेक्टेटर एंड अभिनव टेक्स द क्यू एंड डिवेलप्स इट फर्दर ही सजेस्ट दैट द एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ अ सिंगल स्पेक्टेटर इज इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय द एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ द होल वॉचिंग कम्युनिटी अब ये अभिनव गुप्त जी का एक विशेष कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन है कि मैं नाट्य का आनंद केवल स्वयं ही नहीं लेता लेकिन अगर प्रेक्षागृह में बैठा हूँ इफ आई एम सिटिंग देयर अलोंग विद अदर्स देन आई एम वॉचिंग अलोंग विद अदर्स एंड व्हाट हैपन्स व्हेन आई वॉच एज अ कम्युनिटी फॉर अभिनव साधारणीकरण मीन्स दैट द होल कम्युनिटी is offered the same perceptive experience in the vibhav anubhav vyavichare the resultant sadharanikaran is so strong that all bonds of time and space are set aside for the sake of the emergence of rasa एंड देयर इज ए रियलाइजेशन ऑफ अ यूनिफाइड एक्सपीरियंस फॉर ऑल स्पेक्टेटर्स। तो वो स्पष्ट कह देते हैं कि एक अकेला नहीं देख रहा, कई मिलकर देख रहे हैं, और ये मिलकर देखना एक विशेषता है और उसी से एक विशेष प्रकार का रस है। अतएव सर्व समाजिका नाम एक घनतया एव प्रतिपत्ति ही सुतराम रस परिपोषाय। तो रस के परिपोष के लिए, फॉर द इमर्जेंस ऑफ रस टू बी मोस्ट इफेक्टिव और टू बी अल्टीमेट इमर्जेंस ऑफ रस और व्हाट इज सुतराम परिपोष, फॉर दैट एक घनतया एव प्रतिपत्ति। सो एवरीबडी इज नाउ इन वन सर्कल। इन अदर वर्ड्स, आई एम नॉट एक्सपीरियंसिंग इट नॉट अलोन एज डिटैच फ्रॉम माई डेली एक्सपीरियंसेस, लाइक्स एंड डिसलाइक्स एज सेड अर्लियर, बट नॉट अलोन एज वन सिंगल स्पेक्टेटर, बट दैट आई एम वन ऑफ द स्पेक्टेटर और दिस होल कम्युनिटी ऑफ स्पेक्टेटर्स। All the spectators have the same deeply unifying experience. Now this is a special view that he puts forth, as I have been able to understand it. Maybe I have not understood it correctly. Not only because they are moved by the same thing, but also, as Abhinav postulates, because every spectator's consciousness is colored by the same primordial desire, the seed form of rati, shok, etc. And because there is a consonance among spectators in experiencing that primordial desire as rasa. अब यहाँ एक और कदम बढ़ा देते हैं। पहली बात तो ये कि वीत विघ्न प्रतीति है रस, उसमें किसी प्रकार का सांसारिक विघ्न नहीं होता, इसलिए वो रस है। दूसरी बात कि हम सब इकट्ठे बैठकर देख रहे हैं और एक घनतया ये सब कुछ हो रहा है, वी आर डूइंग इट टुगेदर। नाउ ही सेज समथिंग मच मोर। व्हाट आर वी एक्सपीरियंसिंग? वी आर एक्सपीरियंसिंग द सेम थिंग। This same thing is not the performance on the stage. The same thing is not the drishyan shravya kridaniyak. The same thing is not vibhava anubhava vyabhichari and their sanyog. The same thing is very different. This consonant experience is without any obstruction. It is a unity and a wonder. And in words of Acharya Abhinav Gupta, Sarvesham anadi vasana chitrikrita chetasam. Sarvesham anadi vasana chitrikrita chetasam. वासना संवादात सच अविघ्न संवित चमत्कार। सो नाउ ए चमत्कार हैपन्स, एंड हाउ डज दिस चमत्कार हैपन्स? बिकॉज दोस स्पेक्टेटर्स, इंडिविजुअल एज वेल एज द कलेक्टिव स्पेक्टेटर्स, दे ऑल हैव देयर हार्ट्स और देयर माइंड्स और देयर कॉन्शियसनेस कलर्ड by anadi vasana, vasana samvada such a avigna samvit chamatkara. So now the chamatkar happens that they enter the same samvit because they have tasted their own inner anadi vasana. So here he again postulates a common ground which is present in the hearts of all spectators. Therefore, it may be said that bhava is known as rasa when through natya experience, natyanubhuti or pratiti as the technical term goes, all obstructions such as personal likes and dislikes have been removed from it. Here, vibhavas and others are the obstruction removers. And he uses the, his own words are, sarvatha rasanatmaka vit vigna pratiti grahyo bhav eva rasa. So what has happened is that every kind of vigna has been set aside. It is vita, it has gone. And the bhav has become rasa because there is no obstruction in it. In other words, vyabhicharis, etc. are only apsarakas. They are removing the vigna of every kind. Here vibhavas and others, anubhava and sancharis are the obstruction removers. Tatra vigna apsaraka vibhava prabhrityaha. This is what he states. Now what you see here, excuse me, what you see here is something beyond the chamatkar or vilakshan pratiti of Shankuk. It is not the beautiful form. It is also not what was present in Bhatt Lolat as Anusandhan, because rasa appears by the power of the force, Anusandhan Balat, he says, that you are able to see the emergence of rasa because the bhava gets altered in this way. So Lolat as well as Shankuk, they are still worried about the form. They are still worried about the theatrical activity which is going on the stage. And in fact, in the case of Shankuk, as a matter of fact, in the case of Shankuk, it is this vilakshan pratiti, which is, neither of the four kinds, samyat, mithya, etc. Because it is neither real nor unreal. But the form is such, what you see is such. It is so wonderful that it is a chamatkar. So at this point, the actual seeing of Natya is where rasa happens, because it provides a vilakshana pratiti and it provides something fresh and new, because in the scheme of Shankuk you cannot really feel what Rama felt or any other character felt. The bhava of a historical character is gone. You are now doing an anukriti of it, and this anukriti is done through a form. Now this point is transcended by Bhattanayak, where he brings in Sadharanikaran, where he says now the emotional experience is very important, the emotional experiences of the spectator. Abhinav Gupta takes the emotional experience of the spectator beyond the notion of Vigna Apsarak, beyond the notion of removing the obstructions of all kinds, what is called Abhivyanjanavat, and he goes to ascertain that there is a common experience, and this experience lies in Anadivasana. Now you see, Anadivasana is a very, I wouldn't say confusing, but it's a very deep term, because it is Anadi to whom? And if it is Anadi, then it cannot be personal. Anything which is anadi, like Nritya is anadi. In the fourth chapter, Abhinav Gupta says that Shiva only remembered maya api idam smritam nrityam. So you remember something which existed long time back, and that is anadi. So here again, this concept of anadi vasana therefore is not personal. एंड देयरफॉर द स्पेक्टेटर हैज टोटली ट्रांसेंडेड हिमसेल्फ नॉट इन टर्म्स ऑफ वर्ल्डली लाइक्स एंड डिसलाइक्स ओनली बट ही हैज ट्रांसेंडेड हिमसेल्फ इन टर्म्स ऑफ ऑल संस्कारस एक्सपीरियंसेस एंड वासना दैट ही मे कैरी फ्रॉम दिस लाइफ टाइम और प्रीवियस लाइफ टाइम्स. इन अदर वर्ड्स इट इज द संवित क्रिएटेड by the anadi vasana in which there is this chamatkar which he calls is rasa. So what happens now is the height of an inwardly interior world or inwardness. The inwardness has gone to the point where everything social, everything in samsara has been transcended, and the consonance of the experience of Natya after being a trigger has made the spectator enjoy himself in himself. I mean, that's the only way I can perhaps put it, that he is enjoying or she is enjoying himself in himself, because it is the anadi vasana which is consonating with the experience, with the consciousness, and that becomes the experience of rasa. So this is a great turning point. Not only this kind of thinking can think about shanta rasa as the final rasa from which all rasas emerge and to which all things return. It's a purely metaphysical position. It's not a dramatic position. A dramaturgical position. It is not something which is related to Natya or performance. Natya and performance is now considered only to be some kind of a, not even a catalyst, but just an introductory thing. And it ends up in itself and provides entry into a door in which everything is beyond Natya. Now, I think this kind of thinking prepares a ground for the future theorists. And the ground here then is that rasa would be henceforth defined only in metaphysical terms. You see, the tradition of Bharat Muni is related entirely to prayog. He at some points in some karikas even calls it natya rasa, and some people have kind of jumped onto this the word natya rasa and said that rasa is only in natya. And there were many people who have postulated and who still postulate that Bharat Muni's theory applies only to theater. It cannot apply to your reading a poem or to a painting or to music. It cannot apply to the power of word or music or Gandharva. It cannot. It can only apply to theater. That was one kind of thinking, because people concentrated only on the actual performance. However, the tradition of Bharat Muni, although it went beyond Natya, because Natya had all vidyas in it, all shilpas in it, and it satisfied all kinds of people, in spite of all that, it was maintained that it is something, rasa is there as long as there is something before your eyes. Now, as long as it is before your eyes, there is rasa. But here, at this point, when Abhinav Gupta comes on to give this kind of a explanation about a postulation about rasa, then rasa is an entirely inward experience. Of course, much has been written about the reasons for giving this and for the Shaiv Siddhanta and for the Shiva Sutras connected with it, and the idea that the whole world is a theater and you are watching it, and that parallel does exist. But what it does in practical terms to the art of theater, that art of theater, instead of concentrating on the anukriti, lokanukriti, or anukirtan, or imitation of the world, tends to become a metaphysical experience. So this is something which has prepared a very strong ground in the thinking of Abhinavagupta to provide rasa and theater, something which becomes a handmaiden of later metaphysical bhakti literature. So it is from here that you have this great movement that art is done only for the sake of an Ishtadeva. It is entirely for this reason that art has been pushed out of a so-called secular or worldly, or where you have not just Natya and Loka, or what may be called the world outside theater transforming itself into the world of theater. That whole relationship breaks down, and representation in art therefore becomes only the representation of the Leela of the Ishtadeva, whether that Ishtadeva is Ram or it is Krishna, because that is considered to be the ultimate rasa. The worship of the Ishtadeva is considered to be the only purpose. Bhajiye Ram sab kaam bihai, see, deha dhare tan yeh phal paai, bhajiye Ram sab kaam bihai. So this whole trend begins with Abhinav. It's a trend of taking yourself away from the reality and creating a reality only in terms of the Leela of the Divya Purusha, Leela of the Ishtadev, no matter who is the Ishtadev. So I think Abhinav, some will say, did a great job. Some will say perhaps it is not a great job. In my humble opinion, it is a very a drastic turn, whether good or bad. Of course, we'll continue to have our own opinions on it. But then it makes the whole business of art very inward. It makes us otherworldly. It, of course, works wonder in the literature of bhakti and rasa leela and the formulation of Madhura Ras, and then great works like Ujjwal Neelamani, etc. But if I have been able to communicate, it is something which takes us away from this lokanukriti. You see, it takes us away into our inner world, and for the sake of the inner world. Thank you very much. I have very limited time. I don't know if I have been able to make my submission with some clarity. And now I hand over the floor back to